In the United Kingdom, we, as doctors, look to treat individuals who are at risk of developing problems, and this is something called primary prevention. And in the UK, because it's a health service, this is often done in a population way. So you'll go to your GP, and he'll put a number of numbers into his computer, and out comes a percentage, something called a Q risk score, which tells them the probability of you having a heart attack over the next 10 years. And in the United Kingdom, if that number is over 20%, you're told to take a statin and possibly consider aspirin. If it's over 15%, often diet and lifestyle is recommended. If it's over 10%, diet and lifestyle is discussed. In America and Europe, over 10%, statins would be treated. And a lot of the differences that occur between ourselves and other health sub-economies are because of funding issues. The problem with the system is that the actual algorithm that calculates this is based on things that are not all that modifiable. So you score badly if you're a man and you score badly if you're older. Then there's smoking, diabetes, cholesterol and high blood pressure, which you'll worry about, an element of obesity, which obviously is a current health concern. But the thing that's not included in this is the family history and the implication of family history or ethnicity, and also to a certain extent social deprivation that may or may not be associated with this. And it's been calculated that family history can increase your risk by up to twofold. So if you scored 15% and you had a strong family history, the process could be, it could be 30%. And you're falling between stools for treatment. And the problem with population calculations is that often your GP will click on a button and say you should be on a statin, but nothing specifically is discussed about why, other than a number. And therefore, I have a specific interest in determining individual risk profiles. And we can now do that with something called coronary calcium scoring, which is a very straightforward test. It has about the amount of X-ray radiation as a chest X-ray and takes about 5 minutes. And that tells me whether or not you're furring your arteries or you're not furring your arteries. And it tells me whether the cholesterol is being deposited in your arteries or not. And if the cholesterol is being deposited in your arteries, then obviously the cholesterol is too high and it needs to be lowered. And if cholesterol is not being deposited in your arteries, then there is no need to worry about that at this moment in time. So this is akin to the concept that a 15-year-old boy who has a cholesterol of 8 doesn't fur his arteries at 15. But a gentleman at 65 who has a cholesterol of 6 will suddenly start furring his arteries. And why? Why does that happen? And well, it's because of the vascular integrity. It's to do with the endothelium or the aging of the arteries. So at some point there's a breach in the arterial wall integrity and the cholesterol gets deposited. And at that point, statins will make a difference. At that point, lowering cholesterol is going to reduce the event rate. And at the moment we can see that a lot of clinical studies show that the outcomes on those patients is where you get your best bang for your buck, for want of a better term. But on an individual basis, it's very easy for patients to understand that if I'm now furring my arteries and you've looked at my arteries, then clearly I should take tablets. So this is a much better and refined way of treating for primary prevention.